I want you to find a formula for the general term AN of the following sequence. The sequence, okay, so it's going to be 3/5, negative 4 over 25, 5 over 125, negative 6 over 625, 7 over 3,125, so forth. So what I'm trying to do is have you give me the formula. We're kind of doing the reverse process of what we saw in the previous examples. In the previous examples, I started with a formula and you wrote out the terms. We plugged in numbers for n. But now I'm giving you the plugged in numbers and I want you to tell me the formula. So there's a lot going on, right, with this. If you look at the signs, right, the first term's positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. So it's doing that flip-flopping thing. So let's put that aside for a minute. We have a fraction, numerator and denominator. So let's see what's happening to the numerator. What are my numerators to begin with? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Do you know that it starts at 1?
We're gonna start it at 1, yep. If you wanted to start it a different number, then the formula would be a little bit different. Okay, so you're telling me that the numbers in the numerator are 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, right? And I want to start with n equals 1 as my starting point. So I take this number 1, right? And I'm adding 2 to it to get the numerator 3, right? And then after that, I'm increasing by 1 every time, right? So I think the formula for our numerator is going to be n plus 2. Right? Because when I plug in 1, I'll get 3. You plug in 4 or 2, you get 4. 3, you get 5, and so forth. This is just increasing by a constant every time, and so your formula, it's just n plus 2. Now let's focus on the denominators. What are happening with the denominators?
It's 5 squared.
So 5, and then 5 squared, and then the next one?
Cubed.
5 cubed. So these are all powers of 5, right? 5 to the n. So the only other part that we need to deal with, we've figured out the numerator and the denominator, and now the fact we need to take care of the sign flopping. So because the sign is switching back and forth, your formula is either going to have a negative 1 to the n or a negative 1 to the n minus 1. Okay? Anytime it's flopping, you'll have something that looks like one of those two things. And it just depends on if you start with a positive term or a negative term. Is A1 positive or negative?
Positive.
Positive. So when I plug in n equals 1, which one is going to give me a positive 1?
Negative
1. N minus 1. Right? If I plug in n equals 1 into this first term, I'll get negative 1, and if I plug it into here, I'll get a positive 1. And I wanted the one that was positive. So in front of my formula, I now need to insert in this negative 1 to the n minus 1. Okay, and that's my formula for this. Okay? So if your sequences have a lot going on, which this one did, there's some pattern in the numerator, some pattern in the denominator, this sign change going on, just break it into pieces and look for the pattern in each part. Okay? Kind of dissect it into the individual items. Okay. Any questions before I go on? Okay. So, the examples we've seen so far of sequences, they all have these nice formulas for them. But that's not always true, so I wanted to mention that to you. So that sometimes sequences don't have a simple defining equation. So the most famous, probably, of these would be the Fibonacci sequence. Fibonacci sequence, which I'm going to call F sub n, F for Fibonacci, is defined recursively as the first term is 1, the second term is 1, and then every other term after that is the sum of the previous two terms. Okay, so you could write out the sequence now. Some of the first few terms, 1, 1, and then what would be the next number? 2. You add up the two before it. Next number? 3, 5, 8, 13, right? And then 21, and so forth. So for this sequence, you can't actually find an AN formula like you could in the previous examples that we saw.